All right, guys, we're back staring at my engine bay, and in this video, we're going to talk about density altitude, or DA. So a lot of people are paying attention to this more, primarily because it's one of the metrics shown on your draggy chart, and so people are wondering what it means and what is a good DA, and basically how to determine it's a good time to try to go set some records. So density altitude was developed by a group of scientists that wanted a good scale that they could use to understand the weather conditions. And it was primarily developed for aviation, so pilots could understand how the environment would affect how their plane would fly through the air. So they created this scale where basically starting at sea level, so at zero elevation, 15 degrees Celsius or 60 degrees Fahrenheit, and regular like one bar of ambient pressure, 14.7 PSI, that's basically your zero starting point. And as temperature and pressure varies from that, they adjust the reading so that it basically gives you a relative elevation. And that's what your density altitude is. It's your elevation adjusted for the ambient conditions. Now, from a driving perspective, a lower elevation is better because the higher you go in elevation, the thinner the air is and the less oxygen is in the air. So if you're at a low elevation, the air is more oxygen rich. And that means that the engine can run easier and smoother and will have a more efficient combustion cycle. So the same thing goes for density altitude. You want your DA to be as low as possible in order to have a good chance of setting records. Unfortunately, if you are at a physically higher elevation, your DA is just going to have a tendency to be higher, but there's still an opportunity to at least find the best conditions in your area. Or of course, you can go to an area with lower elevation so that you can have a better opportunity of setting good times. And that's why a lot of people will literally ship their race cars to specific tracks that are known for having better weather conditions, because those weather conditions do matter when you're trying to set a time. Now, another thing a lot of people don't understand about DA is it's not something that you can measure. It's something that you can calculate. So like I said, it's primarily determined by your temperature and your ambient pressure. Now, if you're shooting for a low DA, you should be looking for a low temperature and a high ambient pressure. Now, a low temperature is easy. That's something that obviously you can feel. You can look at the forecast. And if you're trying to, you know, go to the drag strip on a Friday or something, you can check what the temperature will be. And if it's low, it'll be a better opportunity to set good times. Now, the one that a lot of people don't understand is ambient pressure, and that actually has a really big effect on the weather. When you have low ambient pressure, that creates crappy weather conditions. So there will be clouds in the sky, high winds, rain, storms. If you have high ambient pressure, then you'll have a clear forecast, no clouds in the sky, the winds will be calm. Another good indication of that is having a big temperature swing. So without any clouds in the sky, there's nothing really to keep the heat in. So that's why a lot of records are typically broken in the spring or in the fall, because those are the days that you typically, you know, have really cold mornings where you have to wear a jacket on your way to work. But when you're coming home, it's warm. And you can drive home with the windows down because there's a big temperature swing throughout the day. So on days like that, running at night where the temperatures are cool, hopefully still warm enough for your tires to hook up, but cool enough where the engine is really happy, those are the days where you'll have the best opportunity to set your fastest quarter miles, your fastest 60 to 130 or 100 to 200. You know, your car will basically be performing at its best. One last thing I want to touch on. A lot of people ask if there's a way to correct for DA, kind of the same way that we have a slope corrector or several slope correctors out there that try to adjust your draggy times for the slope that you have. And there isn't anything like that. I don't know that I'd actually trust it if there was, just because there are so many things that can influence how your car performs, not just slope and DA, but weight and everything. There are so many different contributors to the times that you run. So I wouldn't try to wait around for that or try to calculate what your car would do at sea level. Just do your testing as scientific as you can. A before and after will tell you way more than one dyno run or one glory run out on the highway. Just enjoy your car. Test it before and after to see the gains and continue from there. So hopefully this helps. If you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do
Doop.